is you shed lonesome tears. But now you're in a wonder run. I wonder what you're doing here. The flame no longer flickers. You're feeling just like a fool. You keep staring into your liquor, wondering what to do. I don't hardly know you, but I'd be willing to show you. I know a way to make you smile. Let me touch you for a while. Drinking whiskey when it should be wine. You keep looking into that mirror, but to me you're looking really fine. I don't hardly know you, but I'd be willing to show you. I know a way to make you. No way to make you smile. Just let me whisper things you've never heard before. Just let me touch you, baby. Just let me touch you for a while. Everything's gonna be alright, 'cause you're the lucky one. You're the lucky one, always having fun. A jack of all trades, a master of none. You look at the world with a smiling eye and laugh at the devil as the train rolls by. Give you a song and I will not stand. You'll be looking at a happy man, 'cause you're the lucky one.
Thank you. Thank you very much, everybody. We are so glad to be here today. Thank you. This is one of the most beautiful theaters, if not the prettiest, that I think that we've ever got the chance to play in. It is unbelievable. I especially like the naked people. Anyway, but, thanks so much for coming out tonight. We are looking forward to playing some music for you tonight, and because that's our job. Oh, you know, it's a little different seeing everybody. It's a little intimidating.
No, I like it.
You like it? I don't know, because when I look over here, I go, oh, I can't look over there. They're looking at me. And then if I go over here, it's like... Okay, sorry.
From the bright sunny south to the war I was sent. Ere the days of my boyhood I scarcely had spent. From its cool shady forests and deep flowing streams, ever fond in my memory and sweet in my dreams. When I had to leave home in our tender years, and my sweet gentle mother so dear to my heart, it grieved me sincerely when we had to part. My kind-hearted father, as he took my hand, as you go in defense of our dear native land, son, be brave but show mercy whenever you can. Our hearts will be with you till you return again. Bible to show me the way through my trials.
else here on earth and to heaven someday. I will shoulder my musket and brandish my sword in defense of this land and the word of the Lord.
Thank you very much. We would like to tell you who this is over here playing the guitar for you.
David.
I ran into Dan at the Walgreens today down the street, and he was buying some new hair gel, and I think it was called a massive manipulator or something. I think is what it was called. Is that what it was called?
I have no idea what it was called.
He said something about manipulating
on there. It's pretty stout. That's all I know.
He's originally from West Rutland, Vermont, and now lives near Ferrum, Virginia, and he's been enjoying an awful lot of success lately with the Oh Brother, Where Art Thou soundtrack. And he's had a long career in this type of music I already had a long career. That's what I meant to say. He's already had a long career in this kind of music. He made some great records with the Lonesome River Band, and he's got his first solo record out that has a really nice Studley picture on the front that we've all enjoyed since it first came out.
It's kind of... pretty close
it
to that.
It only looks a little bit like that, not a lot, but actually, Ron, Dan, Barry, and Jerry are all they're all Soggy Bottom Boys. They played on that record. So we wanted to point out that, and actually, the guys, everybody but Dan wanted me to tell you that Dan has the soggiest of the bottoms. Oh, please make welcome the man that made George Clooney look really good, Dan Tominski.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Just a little farm lad, so busy playing with his little playmate outside the gate. Well, he stopped to watch a truck that was parking next door at the home of his tiny playmate. And he saw his daddy watching too, as the men swiftly walked to the cottage door. He knew seen before. They soon went to work when he heard his daddy say, "Our neighbors are moving today." Sweetheart away. I know, Dad, you don't understand how a heart so young could conceive a plan. I'm only 7 now, but it's just like you say, Daddy, someday I'll be a man. So they can stay and give them all the toys that dear Santa gave, and give them all my pennies in my little piggy bank, pennies that my darling helped me save.
Thank you very much. We'd like to tell you who the man is over there on the end. He brought that tune to the band over 10 years ago. He's originally from Torrance, California, and now lives in Franklin, Tennessee, and he has let us rip off a whole bunch of songs of his through the years. We're very happy about it. We're also happy to say that he has his first solo record out this year, and he has kind of a different look on the front. He's kind of the more subdued stud look than what Dan was going for on his. He wrote every song on that record, and he spent a little time over at my house working on it. I've got a little studio there, and he'd come over there and work on it, and if anybody here has ever been in the studio before, you know that it's not always so fun. It can be a bit humbling, and I'd see him there in the morning sometimes and ask him how it was going, and he'd say, well, I've been working in there, and I just need me. And then I'd go inside and come out after a few hours after Ron had had a few glasses of wine. And I'd say, Ron, how's it going out here? And he'd say, it sounds pretty good. And we found that it really does sound good, and you don't need any wine to listen to it. He's had a profound effect on all of us with his talent and his friendship. Please make welcome one of my favorite musicians in the world, Ron Block.
Today the past is goodbye. Time can't erase a lover's embrace. Can't you hear it calling? A new day dawning. You're longing to find. Oh, and the corner of ambition. I came here to sink or swim and to show them all that they were wrong. And though I never thought I'd make it this far, so the curtains are down for the moment I was someone. There were those in the wings who waited and came this way. Now they're gone. But there's always someone at home who never forgets who you are.
Quietly as in this, I haunt thee.
what's left of two hearts on fire that once burned out of control. You took my body and soul. I'm just a ghost in this house. I don't care if it rains. I don't care if it's clean. I don't mind staying near. There's another ghost here. He sits down in your chair. Just a ghost in this house. I'm just a shadow upon these walls. I'm living proof of the damage heartbreak does. I'm just a
a song written by a guy named Hugh Prestwood, and it was out on the radio about, I'm guessing, at least 10 years ago with a group called Shenandoah, and I knew the song from hearing it there, but I went to a show in Nashville to see a guy named Michael Johnson sing, and he was playing, and he did that song, and I remember thinking, that's the worst thing I've ever heard in my entire life. We have to do it too. So we started doing it for fun, and then we thought, hey, that kind of fits in with the rest of the sad, pitiful numbers that we do all the time.
Forget about it. I'm admitting I was wrong, and I just take what's mine and broke them right out the door. Forget about it. I'll split and I'll be gone, and you'll have memories you'll find hard to ignore. Cause after all, see you sometime, maybe when I will recall how you drove me crazier. Forget about it. When forever's over, I won't remember how much I loved you anymore. Forget about it. Put me out of your head now that you're free and easy. I'll bet on the time. Forget about it. When you're lying in bed just wishing I was there to lay you down. Cause after all, see you sometime, baby, when you will recall how it drove you crazier. Forget about those starry nights, laying by the fireside holding the time. I can't remember when I felt so right, so just forget about it. See me on the street, don't wave, don't try to tease me with your smile. Forget about it. If we chance to meet somewhere, don't think it's 'cause I'm trying to reconcile. 'Cause after all, I'll see you sometime, baby, when I will recall. I could drove me crazy.
That was a song written by one of my favorite songwriters, Robert Lee Castleman. And he wrote that one and a couple songs that we have on our latest record. One is The Lucky One and the other one is Let Me Touch You for a While. And I remember when I heard the last two songs, he was out on the road with us and we were out west and a friend of his brought a tape of a live show of his from like 15 years ago. And I remember he brought it on the bus. He's like, look at this tape. And Dave's friend brought this tape to me. And I'm like, you have to give me that tape. I get that tape. That's mine because we might need to rip you off again. So you have to give that to me. And so he let me borrow it. And I remember listening through it. And then The Lucky One came on there. And I was going, oh, what a great song. I love this song. There's only one thing wrong with it, though. It's happy. Because it was all in first person, and the song was, I'm the lucky one, so I've been told it's reason we love. And I thought, well, maybe we can talk to him about it. Maybe we can get him to change it. We want to, instead of a positive experience, we want a negative experience. Because we don't want anybody leaving our shows feeling good. So but he fixed it. We were really glad. But anyway, so I remember also after that, I was listening on and I heard Let Me Touch You for a While come on there. And I remember listening to it going, oh, I love this song too. Good night. Wonder what the name of it is. So I got out the tape box that listed all the titles on there. And I looked at it and I went, do what? We can't do a song called Let Me Touch You for a While. How am I going to tell the guys? So I remember we were getting ready to work on our last record, and we were sitting around and listening to songs, and I said, I got these two really, really great songs. One's called the Lucky One, and then there's this other one. And I remember them going, what's the name of it? And I told them, and they go, they go, let me touch you for a while, please. And it was either Barry or Dan who fell on the floor laughing. And anyway, but we found that if you say it enough times, the shock will kind of wear off. And then if you put it at the beginning of the show, you don't have to say the name of it. Anyway, we'd like to feature Ron right now on the title song of his brand new record called Faraway Land. One, two,
days to me, no time on the hands, a runaway to a place in me, to a faraway land. When home seems so far from me, heaven's lights look dim, it's just as far as my deepest home, where my heart's father lives. His quiet voice speaking in silence every day. If I'm alone and listen to the words he has to say, I'll walk in his spirit, see him in my face. I'll be
like to introduce this man over here playing the dobro for you. He's originally from Warren, Ohio, and now lives in Nashville, Tennessee. And he's been a hero of all of ours since, of course, the second we heard him. He's regarded as one of the finest musicians in the world. We never thought that we'd have the chance to record with him in 1,000,000 years. And now to stand next to him every night, we are forever enchanted. Please make welcome the greatest dobro player the world has ever known, Jerry Douglas.
Thank you. How y'all doing? Nice to be here in Louisville again. I like to know who I'm talking to. You know, and there's a chance that some of you may not, maybe shouldn't be sitting together, you know. So I'm going to play a couple songs for you. The first one's called a tribute to Heather O'Donnell, and it's an Irish number. You're fast up here, though. You already knew that. And the second one is called A Monkey Let the Hogs Out. And I don't know what to say about that one, really. You know, it's not an Irish number, though. It's international. That's what it is. Yeah, but it comes from a story a friend of mine told me about his next-door neighbor who won an orangutan in a poker game, and that's as far as I can go with that. So it's time to play. It's nice talking to you. It's great to see you.
Thank you. story and it won't take long. About a lazy farmer who wouldn't hoe his corn. The reason why I never could tell. For that young man was always well. He planted his corn in the month of June. By July, it was up to his eyes. Come September, there came a big frost, and all the young man's corn was lost. Just begun. Said, young man, have you hauled some corn? Well, I tried and I tried and I tried in vain, but I don't believe I raised one grain. Giving me the devil cause I wouldn't hold corn.
Don't choose me because I am faithful. If your heart settles on me, I'm for the taking. Take me from longing or leave me behind. I would be for you. heart settles on me, I'm for the taking. Leave me longing or leave me
behind. Also been working on a tuning video. And this may be it.
This is a double album.
With a big picture of my butt on it.
That ought to sell a few copies. Double platinum.
Oh, Lordy.
In constant sorrow all through his day, but I am a man of constant sorrow. I've seen trouble all my day. The place where I was born and bred, the place where he was born and bred. For 6 long years I've been in trouble. Friends to help me now. He has no friends to help him now. Let's fare thee well, my whole true lover. For I'm bound to ride that northern railroad. Perhaps I'll die upon this train. Perhaps you'll die upon this train. See no more. But there is one promise that is given. I'll meet you on God's golden shore. He'll meet you on God's golden shore.
Thanks very much.
It's funny because when I first got the call to do that song, of course, I was very excited that I was going to get to do this voiceover. So I called home and told my wife that I had the chance to do this voiceover for George Clooney. And she said, "Oh, Dan, that's great. What's a voiceover?" And I went on to explain that when you went to the movie theater and you saw George Clooney up on the big screen, that you'd be looking at him, but you'd be hearing my voice coming out. She said, "Dan, that's my fantasy." It's very, very sad because it's very, very true.
Thank you.
I've got a feeling it's not only her fantasy, Dan. It's not mine. It's not mine.
Oh, we'd like to take a minute and tell you who this is playing the bass for you, folks. He's originally from Kingsport, Tennessee, and now lives near Greenville, Tennessee, on his grandmother's farm. She's given him 63 acres of rolling Tennessee hills, and he lives there with his bride and his dog, Booger. And Barry has been working with Booger because he wants him to become a fine hunting dog. And I have to say that I really was never around hunters till Barry, and because I actually had a yard about as wide as it is from where I'm standing to where you're sitting, and I actually remember the first time I saw a possum, I went, "Kitty." And anyway, but I learned a lot about the outdoors and hunting from Barry, and he also opened the door to a lot of what I didn't realize you needed to be a hunter, such as special outfits to wear, like. You know, having a matching pantsuit when you go and hunt, you need that. A little jacket, cap, and depending on how serious you are, you might need your matching face mask. So Barry has a lot of those things and likes to often take pictures of himself in his hunting outfits. We've seen him, a picture of him on the bus before, and like this, holding one of the things he likes to go on a shooting spree for. And he likes to shoot ducks and quail, your occasional dove, and his favorite, the gobbler, which... I remember when I knew that he was into shooting, what's a gobbler? I didn't even know. It's a wild turkey. And but I didn't know besides, the matching outfits and, you know, and the special guns that you need, and your hat and face mask that you might even be able to buy videos to watch, special videos for hunting fans. And I remember the first time I walked in on him watching one of those. It was on the bus, and I also didn't know that you could buy little horns to toot on, depending on what animal you liked. And he was watching a turkey hunting video when I saw them, and he was tooting on the little horn. And so I walk in, and I'm like, well, this is nice. You know, there's the guy sitting in the dark in a hunting outfit. And on the TV screen was this little turkey. Yeah. And I remember at one point, that turkey had a head. And a few moments later, no head. Nowhere was there a head. And I remember I said, good night, Barry. What are you watching on TV? And he goes, what do you expect, Alison? It's a hunting video. And I remember that particular tape was, you know, special for those who like to shoot the gobbler. And it was called The Ultimate Spring. And Barry also was a fan of the Duck Commander, if anybody knows that man. And but he had The Ultimate Spring, and then he said that he had The Ultimate Spring 1, 2, and 3. And I'm like, what's the difference? And he goes, well, one was made in 92, one was made in 93, one was made in 95. And then and then he also pointed out a very interesting fact about what was different about the videos, which I hadn't thought of, is that they were different turkeys.
We keep trying to do the catch and release thing, but it just doesn't really work.
Oh. Oh. Besides all of that, I've been playing music with Barry in this band for over 12 years, and hands down, he is the finest bass player in this style of music. That's Barry Bales, everybody. Look at him go.
Maybe he'll fly.
conductor, trying to sort the whole thing out.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
We'd like to tell you who this is playing the drums for you. To look at him, you wouldn't think it, but he's a foreigner. He's from up in that there, Canada. And we were just up there, actually, on our last trip out, and we saw many of his people.
Many, many people.
You may recognize him. He was a longtime member of Emery Lou Harris's Nash Ramblers band. And before that, C-Train. C-Train. And he was out with us last year, and we were hoping he would join us again. He's one of the nicest people you'll ever meet. That's Larry Adamanuick, everybody.
Speak right to my heart. Without saying a word, you can light up the door. Try as I may, I could never explain.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you very much. I was looking back there, I'm like, is there somebody signaling to them to stand up? I was looking back, like, oh, there's nobody. Wow, thanks. Thank you.
Back to June.
What can I do? I'm falling in love. I'm just an old hound dog roaming around. Oh Lord, I've got all this in heaven above. Oh Atlanta, I hear you calling. I'm coming back to you one fine day. Hey, no need to worry, there ain't no worries. Well Atlanta, hear me calling. I'm coming back to you one fine day. Hey, no need to worry, there ain't no worries.
Thank you. That's Ron Block. Dan Taminsky. Barry Bale. Jerry Douglas. And Larry Adamanuick. Thank you so much for coming out tonight, everybody. We've had a wonderful time. Good night.
As I went down in the river to pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear the robe and crown, good Lord, show me the way. Oh, brothers, let's go down, let's go down, come on. Down. Come on, brothers, let's go down, down in the river to pray. As I went down in the river to pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear the starry crown, good down, come on down, come on, mothers, let's go down, down in the river to pray. As I went down in the river to pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear the starry crown? Good Lord, show me the way. Let's go down, come on down. Come on, fathers, let's go down, down.